If you deny the devils, if you deny the existence of Lucifer, if you deny the existence of sin, of hell, of eternal punishment, you automatically deny Christ's salvation. You automatically deny God's goodness. Deny God's goodness, and the whole purpose of the cross, the whole incarnation is destroyed. In fact, you can't deny the existence of Lucifer without being led inevitably to deny the divinity and the function of Christ as Savior. What's the purpose in Christ coming? What is the purpose? To make a nice land, to give us more eggs, more happy lives on us? No, he came to save us from sin, S-I-N. So that's the reason. Now, the reason I say it's the apostasy is this, that there is evidence, and I cannot get over the evidence, and I'm one of millions, that we are today in the grip of the beginning of a major apostasy. That is, overnight, as it were, Bernard, in a church which 30 years ago was peopled with solid lines and ranks of clergymen and nuns and priests and lay people, all believers, nobody ever questioning the fundamentals or even the accidentals. Overnight, we suddenly turn around, we have cardinals who don't believe and we know they don't. We have bishops that don't believe and we know they don't. We have priests that don't believe and we know it. We have nuns that don't believe. We have whole segments of the population that have stopped going to mass, stopped going to confession. They don't believe any longer because there's a rule in belief which is absolutely categoric. And by an example, let me tell you what it is. If I say I love you, but I never look at you, I never buy you any roses, I never buy you a meal, I don't see you at night or in the morning, I don't say good morning, good evening. The next time I tell you I love you, you can say, well, big joke. what does love mean? I believe in God. Well, if you believe in God, then why are you violating His rules? And why do you deny the dogmas of His church, which you know is His true church and is infallible? So they have lost their faith, they're apostatic, they're apostates. The difficulty is this, with disbelief. This, I make a comment about certain cardinals in the United States, certainly some archbishops in Canada where you live, and many, many priests and many bishops throughout the United States. When you lose your faith, do you know you've lost it? You couldn't, because otherwise you get it back. They don't know. They think you're stupid because you have retained these so-called superstitions and myths. They don't know. And that's the curse of disbelief. Once he destroys the gift, hey, fella, you can't believe any longer. You are incapable of it. And only His mercy can grasp by the nape of the neck and lift you out of that morass. And He doesn't always do it. And remember, too, that I think we should all remember that it's very easy to lose your faith, far easier at least than you think. I need never doubt a dogma. I need never attack some rule of the church. I need never criticize the Bible and yet lose my faith because I'm unfaithful to my vow of marriage if I'm married, my vow of celibacy if I'm a priest, my vow, my obligation not to steal if I really am a thief, a robber, my obligation not to kill another human being, not to murder them. If I violate any of those things, faith is immediately chipped away. And the moment, and the more I deepen into that, faith disappears. So I can leave my faith and say, no, I want to believe all those things, but I can't any longer. And the last thing to notice about faith is it's not an emotion. It's knowledge, Bernard. What happens in faith is the will, the mind proposes a proposition. God exists. God is my creator. Jesus saved me. There is a hell. The Pope is infallible. The church is the church of God, outside of which there's no salvation. And my will freely locks my mind into it and says, take it, accept it, blindly, without proof. That's faith. But it's knowledge. And St. Paul says it's knowledge through a glass darkly. But that means that when I do believe, when I receive Christ in the Blessed Eucharist, when I say the Rosary, when I make the Stations of the Cross, when I go to Mass, when I fulfill my obligations in my state of life, I'm in contact spiritually and supernaturally with God, and I know Him, but I don't know what I know, unless sometimes by intuition He gives me a knowledge of it, or unless I come to the hour of death and then I suddenly see all I know and all I don't know. So it's a knowledge, and we mustn't forget that. Satan wants to corrupt that knowledge.